This month's free miniature of the month is none other than a formidable Assault Intercessor. Assault Intercessors specialise in taking the fight to their enemy, and in this video we'll be showing you how to paint one of these awesome miniatures in the colours of the Dark Angels. We'll be using less than 10 paints to get this miniature striking down Xenos filth on the battlefield in no time at all. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about it. The series is linked in the description box below. The paints you'll need to follow along with this guide are listed on screen now. These are the colours of the Dark Angels, but feel free to use your imagination and paint your miniature however you like. Also on screen now are the additional tools we've used in this guide. These are our recommendations, but feel free to use whatever brushes you're comfortable with, and if you don't have mediums at home, you can swap them out with water. Now your miniature might look a little bit different to this one, don't worry. You may receive a slightly different variety of Assault Intercessor, but the techniques shown in this tutorial will allow you to paint whichever variety you've taken home with you. The first thing we need to do is undercoat the miniature, and for this we've chosen to use Chaos Black, as this will work really well with that dark green armour. You'll also need the paint pot that matches the undercoat, in this case it's Abaddon Black. This will just help us out if we make any mistakes later on. So for the first stage of this guide, all we're going to do is go over the black areas with Abaddon Black. Now it might seem a little strange that we're doing this, considering that the model is already undercoated in Chaos Black. We're doing this just because the spray can has a slightly different finish to the paint from the pot. And if we make any mistakes later, this'll just help us out. Abaddon Black is a base paint, so we need to thin it down with a touch of water before we apply it. But as it's going over a black undercoat, we should only need one coat. You don't need to worry about being neat here, just make sure you get all of those black details. And with the black done, we're now going to move on to that characteristic green armour. For this we'll be using Caliban Green and a small base brush, just to help us be neat. Again, we'll need to thin this down with a little bit of water, and this time we'll need to do a few coats of paint. This'll just make sure we get a smooth and even coverage. Once your first coat's dry, apply a second one. As you can see, this gives us more coverage. When you're doing this, just try and avoid those black areas we've already painted. However, if you do make any mistakes, just take some Abaddon Black and tidy them back up. And with the armour done, we're now going to paint the red areas. So this is the chainsword and the gun casing, as well as the eye lenses too. Again, we'll need to apply a couple of thin layers to make sure we get a nice smooth coverage. And just be careful around those painted areas, as it'll save us time if we don't have to do any tidying up. Once the red's dry, we're going to move on to the wraithbone areas. We're just going to be painting the chest eagle in this colour. Again, we're sticking with that small layer brush to help us be neat here. The next thing we're going to do is paint the leather pouches using Rhinox hide. We'll also be using this colour to paint the belt. Just remember to keep a fine point on your brush to help you be neat. This is a nice rich brown for leather areas. Now we're going to move on to the silver details. This is areas on the gun and also the chainsword, as well as a few other details on the miniature. It's quite normal for paints to separate in the pot when they've been stood for a while, so make sure you give it a good shake before you apply it to the model. This will make sure you get a nice smooth consistency. Again, be as neat as you can, as it'll save time tidying up, but if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with the previous colours. When you finish using metallic paints, it's a good idea to change your paint water. This will stop any metallic flakes getting into your non-metallic paints and making them shiny. And with that silver finished, all the base coats are now on the miniature and it's looking awesome. With all the base coats done, we're now going to move on to applying some shades. And we're going to start off by applying a recessed shade of Rattling Grime to the armour panels. A recessed shade is where we just apply it to the panel lines. This avoids changing the colour of the flat surfaces, but gives us plenty of depth in the recesses. Be as neat as you can with this, but don't worry, just tidy back up with some Caliban Green if you make any mistakes. Rattling Grime may be a contrast paint, but it is perfect to use as a recess shade. It's really nice and grimy, and it will give us lots of depth on the miniature. With all those recesses shaded, we're now going to apply Rattling Grime again, this time mixed with Contrast Medium. And this is two parts medium to one part Rattling Grime. If you don't have medium, you can use water instead. What this does is thin down the paint so that it's more subtle on the miniature. We'll be applying this over all the metallic details, red and the brown too. Now you'll see that that rattling grime has darkened down our red, so if you want to just layer back over with some Mephiston red, that'll just tidy it up and make it much brighter. Just be careful to leave that shade in the recesses. And with that shade done, your model is now looking suitably grimy. Now we're going to move on to our next shade using Seraphim Sepia on the Wraithbone Chest Eagle. This is a great shade for this. It'll add some depth without altering the original colour too much. And with that shade applied, your model is more than ready to take down the Xenos on the battlefield. However, if you'd like to follow along with this guide, we're going to show you one simple step to take your paint job to the next level. And the final extra stage is an edge highlight of all that power armour. For this, we'll be using Warpstone Glow and a small layer brush. When you're doing this, just take your time and use the edge of your brush where you can. Doing this will give you a really quick and easy highlight. When you're edge highlighting, you don't need to highlight every single edge. Just pick out a few prominent ones and focus on those. You can do as much or as little of this as you want, it's really up to you. Just take your time and work your way around the model. And now your Assault Intercessor is finished, ready to charge onto the battlefield and cut through the enemy. You can see that our model is based using Armageddon Dust, and if you'd like to learn more about basing, you can check out our video about it. Head to your local Warhammer store to claim this awesome miniature for free or order it online now. Also, you can tune into the Warhammer Twitch channel where we'll be painting this miniature live. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, you can head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be happy to help, or check out citadelcolour.com. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video and we'll see you next time. Bye!